It is unfortunate that very little evidence of the Gama's first sea journey and its backgrounds are available. What we know is based on the historiographical narrative built up mostly by the 16th century Portuguese chroniclers like Castaneda, Barros, Rosario, Goiz, and Corriea, whose elaborations are mainly based on the roteiro, which is a modest description of the itinerary of the trip and the specific events in the majority part of the voyage by a certain sailor, Alvaro Velho of the Gama Team. The roteiro was first preserved at Coimbra and then at Porto, where it was discovered and published in Portuguese in 1838 by Diogo Kopke, a German then working at the Polytechnic of Porto. In this king, manuals two later, one to the king and queen of Castile, another to cardinal protector Rome, informing the achievement were also appended. The English version edited by E.G. Ravenstein was published by Hakluyt Society, London in 1898, further appending the two letters of Serenegi, an Italian merchant residing at Lisbon at the time of journey, who wrote to a gentleman in his native place at Florence, describing in details of the journey and its outcome, including its commercial consequences. Gasper Corriea, an important early Portuguese historian of the period, who served Albuquerque as a scrivener and lived in Goa from 1514 to up to his death in 1566, published the famous Lindas de India, that is, Legend of India, in 1551, in which a lot had been explained in detail about the first voyage of Gama, in little bit different perspective. He had claimed to have access to the important paper of Albuquerque in this regard, and also had the possession of the diary of priest Joam Figueiro, who was stated to be in Vasco's fleet. Other chroniclers mostly used the text and context of the roteiro with little situational modification, and it is not clear whether they have gone through any other available texts of the time or met any survivor of the voyage. In all publication and narration, very little is said about the background of Vasco da Gama. Therefore, the selection of Vasco da Gama belonging to a minor nobility with not much sea voyaging experience as the leader and the captain major to address the most formidable challenge of the voyage is a mystery. Vasco da Gama was born around 1460 as the third son of Estevão da Gama, the commander of the fort of Sines, and a noblewoman, Isabel Sodré, in a small seashore town of Sines under the purview of military order of Santiago, which by the time came under the direct patronship of the Portuguese crown. Vasco attended a school 70 miles away in bustling town of Ivora Hills, a larger place where he came into contact with the outside world with large stone buildings, streets, vineyards. He studied mathematics, navigation, and astronomy, and like his father, joined the ranks of the military order of Santiago. He was soon recognized by its patron king João II and was sent to Setúbal, south of Lisbon, and then to the Algarve region of the country to siege French ship as an act of vengeance against the French government for disrupting Portuguese shipping from Africa. Gama, the energetic, short-tempered young man, was a staunch Catholic with complete devotion to the Portuguese crown, and his focused approach and indomitable firmness were the qualities well noticed by the crown. It is not clear who had identified him first as the leader. However, Corriea had an interesting story in this regard. King Manuel I, in Corriea's view, a king much inclined to astronomy, once decided to go ahead with the India plan. He consulted the celebrated Jew Abraham Jacuto, the royal astronomer of the court, and after much divination, Jacuto informed the King Manuel I that he will discover India in a very short time, and it will be discovered by two brothers, his subjects, and since God has ordained this, he will show you the path in choosing them. Manuel, greatly assured by the prediction, revived the half-abandoned project of ship construction, and one day, when Gama was crossing the business room where the king sat, his gaze fell on him and his heart became turbulent. He called him and asked to serve for the voyage, which Gama agreed. Later in dinner, when the king asked if he had any brother, Gama modestly put forward the name of his older brother Paulo da Gama, who was, however, in trouble with justice on account of having wounded a judge in Setúbal. the matter which the king resolved. The officers and men in Gama's armada were selected very carefully, and several of them had been with the Bartholomew Diaz in the rounding of the Cape. It is estimated altogether 170 men were there in the armada. The trip was well funded with the money from Guinea gold and the windfall sums that had become available as a result of Jews' expulsions and loans from German and Italian bankers. The Gama brothers each were assured 2,000 gold crusaders. The members of the crew were paid much more than usual going rate, of which some were in advance to provide maintenance of their families while they were away at sea, probably for 3 years.